Uchumi Supermarkets has announced plans to shut down its operations in Uganda and Tanzania. The move comes as part of restructuring efforts led by Chief Executive Julius Kipng’etich to revive the ailing retailer. And as Michael Karanja now reports, the plan is to first ensure Uchumi is profitable in Kenya before seeking growth in the regional markets.
Turnaround has become a word synonymous when it comes to describing Uchumi Supermarkets. Having risen from the ashes like the proverbial phoenix in 2011, the retailer is now in need of another major overhaul if it is to survive in the market. Faced with limited options, Uchumi management has taken radical steps to ensure the listed firm. First on the block was the sale of non-core assets as Uchumi seeks to raise 2 billion shillings to pay off debtors. And now to seal revenue leakages, Uchumi has shut down its subsidiaries in Uganda and Tanzania, which is termed as loss-making. According to Uchumi CEO Dr. Julius Kipng’etich, both subsidiaries have not made a profit in over 5 years, but accounted for 25% of the retailer's operating costs.
Uchumi has gone through some challenges, but those challenges are now behind us. And with my appointment and that of Willie and our COO and many other senior members of staff who are coming, Uchumi will be back.
The focus for Uchumi in the short term is to get its Kenyan operations back to a profitable position before looking to new markets for growth. Competition in the retail space has been heating up, with Nakumat, Taskies and Naivas taking up most of the market share. The entry of global stores such as Carrefour and The Game has only intensified the competition domestically. Uchumi has stores in both countries but has not announced how much it would be raising from the sale. Uchumi has written to the Capital Markets Authority seeking approval for the planned sale of assets and is waiting for a response from the regulator. The supermarket chain posted a half-year loss of 262.3 million shillings compared to a net profit of 106.9 million shillings recorded a year earlier. Michael Karanja, KTN Business.